Yeah.
Okay.
Cool. We'll continue where we left off last time. Yeah, so okay, I'll just go to the last. If you go to the end of the page, like for example, scroll down also, right? Scroll down, it doesn't, that's what a hierarchy is. Like you don't have to give everything equal weight for the, no, I
Okay.
mean if you scroll down, like that scroll down button itself on the top
Ha
landing
ha ha.
itself, that so you can just you can rank it accordingly, what needs to be the most important and what needs to be also then match it with the what the user expects also at this page. So right now user anyways is expecting to scroll down. You don't have to give so much of importance to the scroll down thing over here. So
Okay.
like that you can think about, you can work with, you can work on the hierarchy with what the user expects at that on the page as well. Now if you go now for
Okay.
example about us also, now this is more at the user level. Like about us looks like a button at the moment. I'm not sure if it's a
Oh,
button.
this, yeah, no, this is supposed to be an image, but I didn't know, like, I couldn't find any images, appropriate images to put in here. So it has a block.
So here about us, like I wouldn't expect the testimonials also on the about us, right? I would expect like you talking about the organization in about us. Testimonials would be like a different section itself. So that
No, it will
is
be in the same section in About Us only, below this.
you have any description?
No, I haven't designed any of this.
Okay, sure, no issues. But yeah, generally if you're keeping the testimonial, it's generally better, like even if you're combining it with about us, you can have it like I would expect like some form of like a description. It doesn't have to be like heavy, it's just like some one or two lines in general. If you look at any of the landing pages, you can go to like websites like landingbook.com and all, where you'll be able to understand like how about us can be structured. So that is one feedback. And then there was now back to top also, right? Things like back to top. It doesn't have to be so important because if you scroll down a little more, there are multiple CTAs that I can see at the bottom. So here there's like events, submit, and then back to top as well. Back to top is not as important as submit or events. I just want to, and so yeah, Landing Folio is another website that you guys can check out. We can all, I can also share more resources after the,
Okay.
class, after the competition, so that
Yes, that would be
will
helpful.
help.
No,
Are
I mentioned back to top everywhere because the login option is here and there's no other place where you can log in. So you need to come back here in order to log in and submit.
So
So that's
one thing
why
you
that
can
was the
do
reason.
also is write like if the page becomes, so one thing is that it depends, like is the page too long or is it short enough? If the page is too long, you can also have it like at the bottom, like a feed. What do you call that? Like at the bottom, generally, like the, you can also keep it at the bottom as well if it's very important, right? It does, you don't have to come back on the top as well. So
Okay.
if it's short enough, it's not like a lot that the user has to scroll right now. As I see, it's not the user has to scroll a lot to come till the top. So it's not, you can give the button if you want to, but it's not that important to highlight it so much. But I understand where you're coming
Okay.
from. Like the thought process is really nice. Maybe the visual design can be a little better.
Okay.
And if you go to events also, can you go to events page? I just wanted to understand how is this organized? Like, how will the events be organized? Is it like organized like let's say if
Downwards. So this will be one block. So there will be blocks like this about a different event. And when you click on one, you can go to another page where you see the full event, full
got it. And if
details.
I have like five, six events, how is that organized? Like
Below this,
below this.
it'll go on increasing downwards.
Cool. Looks cool. Sounds good. Just that one more feedback would be that probably the black text color with the yellow background is not matching so well. Probably you can try out something else also.
Yeah,
But
and this again, it's not a black. This thing, it was supposed to be an image holder. So the images will come in this
no,
way.
I'm not talking about this. I'm talking about the events part, the events text with the yellow background. I mean, it's
Okay.
not working well. So there's something called generally, even if you're using a black color, right? Generally, what people do is you can reduce the opacity by a little so that whatever is in the background mixes with the text that is in front and it looks consistent with the overall thing. Or
Okay.
the other approach is where you actually match the hue. So there's HSL colors that is there. You can match the yellow color and take it look to the darker side. So at least it looks from the same family. Here it looks
Okay,
that
yeah.
you've used 000 and then there's like a yellow color which is like completely different.
Yeah.
It's more smaller feedback, but it's a it helped me personally. It if
Yes,
you
yes.
can try you can try doing that also. So that's it from
Yeah,
my side.
definitely, definitely.
Otherwise, I like the thinking process, to be honest, like the way you thought about it. Maybe it just needs to match a little more with the it's more about, so there are different areas to each designer. One is like who's more of a strategist, one is who is more of a tinkerer, and then someone who's more of a pixel perfectionist. And which involves a lot more craftsmanship as well. So that is something that I think you can work on, like the just perfecting the pixel, but otherwise the thinking process is in the right direction.
Okay, sure. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Hey, Devika.
Hello.
I really liked how you went an extra step to make the presentation and not just Figma. So, congratulations.
Thank you.
The yellow and blue, I think, goes really well together. I like the colors. So,
Thank
starting from
you.
the top again. This is not the first page, right? Can
Yeah,
you?
this is the first.
Yeah, so here you can see, right? About navigation bar chart font sizes are much bigger than, let's say, new members signed up here, or I think they are equal to your CTA font size. So
Yeah.
if you do some research or maybe during the competitive analysis, you see usually the font sizes in the top navigation are much smaller because at this point when the user has landed here, it's just used to switch between sections, but I want the user to focus more on the content in the section.
Okay.
That you can focus on when it comes to hierarchy. And similarly, about events and contactors ka size, and then you see the size of the circle. So circle is much bigger, profile circle, but all of them are
Yeah.
supposed to be at the same hierarchy, right? They are supposed to take the same attention by the user because they're at the same level.
Yeah, correct, correct.
Profile here right now, profile is being highlighted a lot, so maybe you can look into that. Second is so here, new member and sign up here, all of them are in the same visual style, right? So I do not know if I probably as a user, I won't be assuming that any of it is clickable or is a link, right? Because it's in the same visual style. So when you have to, let's say here,
Okay.
sign up here is supposed to be a link. So maybe you can play around with the color of the sign up here text or the font weight. Let's say I make it bold so that I can highlight that it's tappable, right?
Oh, yes.
I can underline it. So you can look into these things so that as a user, I need not to even read new member or here. It should take my attention that, okay, this is another option.
Okay, yes.
And when you click, so here you have given, so submit as a word, when we hear, it's an action-oriented word, right? Submit something. So when I click on submit, I assume that I'm submitting something, but I have not filled anything, right?
Okay, yeah.
So maybe you can think about what copy should go. So that's also equally important. And then here you have written student coordination team welcomes you. So again, you might want to think that if W and U again needs to be in uppercase, right? Because it's a sentence.
Okay. I
Right?
thought it'd be consistent if I use every word in the same way. That's why I kept it that way.
But you can't change the grammar when it comes to consistency. So yeah,
Yeah.
again maybe. And again, if you go to submit, can you please click on that? I think you are taken to the form. So here, what was the scene? I mean, you have to fill both the forms at the same time
I think so, yeah.
because you have,
These two are two different forms, right? One
right?
is about student branch details and one would be for event report details.
So no, when I land here, do I need to fill both of them or either of them?
That depends. Like if you are here to fill in only the student branch details, then you can just fill that, or you will have to fill both.
Okay, so when I'm filling both, probably maybe you want to think that I shouldn't need to submit twice, right? Because that's one process. And then if I click on submit again, when I click on submit, I think you are going to give some feedback to the user that your responses have been taken. So
Yeah, a pop-up.
again, if I submit the student branch details, a pop-up comes up. Then again, I close the pop-up. I fill the event report. I do submit it again. Again, the pop-up comes up. So again, that goes into a bigger process. It's likely to higher drop-off, so you can think about that.
Okay, yeah, sure.
Let's scroll down, I mean, to the next page.
Next is the
So
contacts
there's also
page.
event thing student. So all your headers, let's say contact us, student branch details, all of them are very close to your navigation bar, right? So they're as
Yeah.
close to the navigation bar as to the elements of the same section, right? So I do not know contact us belongs to about or contact us belongs to the section, the elements below that, because it's somewhere in the
Yeah.
center. So using spacing, maybe you can try to utilize the white space better and, create that relationship between sections.
Okay, yes. I keep that in mind.
Yeah. I guess that was it.
Okay then. Thank you.
No worries. All the best.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Thank you
Devika.
for all your feedback. It was really, really useful.
My
Thank you
pleasure.
so much, Devika. So yeah,
Thank you.
before moving to the next participant, the remaining participants, please note down that presentation time is only 3 minutes. Just have a look into it. So yeah, our next participant is Subramanya.
Yeah, I hope I'm audible, right?
Yeah, you're audible.
A minute, I'll just share my screen. Yeah, is it visible now? Okay,
Yeah, it's
yeah, can I
visible.
start it out? Yeah. Yeah, hi out there. I'm Subramania from SIT. It's just, and coming to the topic itself, it's all about student coordination team. What we focus about or what we are telling about has to be something which is going to explore as what is the need of SE. As all the mentors have told, it's all about images it's going to explore as what we are trying to do. And SET is all about the coordination, bringing the people, connecting the people, networking them, and making them know what exactly IEEE can do. And that's what we need to, what I'm trying to emphasize in the landing page. It has to be very simple, but it should mention them. We are there for the student, by the student, and to the student. Exploring it's just a color context which is mentioning as breeze as it is, and it has to be very cool. At the same time, it has to be promising. And that's what the landing page talks all about. It's just as simple as it is because we can't say only the students is going to landing on this page. It might be a faculty, it might be an oldish person, or it might be a person who is just dragging towards IEEE things. When he comes in, he just need to know we are doing something which is going to connect the people from all the means. And that's the base thing. As other participants have told that we need to have two pages. It's going to do all those things. Before going to that, the SCT is what all about the events are going on or what exactly we are doing is mentioned in the second page. Once he enters into the SCT, the base thing is what exactly SCT is going to do or what the blocks or contents or stories which are leading to the saga of learning has to be mentioned. At the same time, events, resources, frequently asked questions. These are some delighted points which a person who enters a website has to know. It's all about your journey and our support, which deals the brand of IEEE in a greater version. And just for the convenience, I just made the events page. The events page is all about telling whether he can participate and what all events has been done now. It has to be very simple, very precise, and neatly monitored. We have something like specific motion. A log presentation is going to tell, okay, you have been late for this event, so you can try for the other events. It's a hierarchy method. It's going to represent the most recent events and the upcoming events in this place. It's going to tell how many days are remaining or how many hours are remaining, what is the status of that event. When he clicks on it, we may actually develop what exactly the event was, the winner's list, and what are the things happening in there, so it could keep the people more connected towards it. And join the Discord, since everything is going on Discord, we need to connect, and connection is more important than anything. And coming to the two forms which are told, student branch details. What exactly I feel is once a person has logged in, you can see that once he logs into it, he don't need to have login pages and all. But the whole idea of SET or IEEE is to connect people and make more people join IEEE So we have a button is going to tell that refer to IEEE, which would bring more people from that person. Once a person logs in, I don't need to take all the details from the person. It has to be very simple. So once Subramania logs in, his email ID, IEEE ID, everything will be gotten. And his institution will also be marked, and his name is also marked. These fields are there. What we expect from the student branch is, what is the strength of the SP, or what is the position of the person who is filling this whole form, and what exactly or where, how we can connect with the particular student branch. It has to be through the LinkedIn or Instagram or Facebook, these things, and exactly the only version that is going to change constantly is the counselors, and the counselors details is something we need to fetch from the time. Location, since to brand it on from the Google Maps and all. And this is some small checkbox to make sure everything goes smooth in the association level. And yeah, coming to the SP events details, I personally prefer everything to be more simpler and more informative in its nature. So just coming to the name of the event, date of the conduction, type of the event, either it's workshop or kind of, or any other event, you can simply mention it on online, offline things. It's Corona time, all we know. And brief description and participation instance, along with the upload, which is going to mention which file he has uploaded, because I personally feel mentioning what he has uploaded is something which is very important when a person is filling the form. This is what this SP event details has to talk all about. And again, once he person logs in, we can get all the details from the net. It's back-end issues. And just coming to the final page, the contact us. As the whole SAT is talking about, it's all about connecting the people. Though many people landing into the page, they don't know what exactly they're expecting from us. We just want to give the love, spread the love, spread the community building, and spread the networking. So we just ask them whether they have shy to talk with us. They can just mail us out. They drop the email. We are going to get them what they are expecting for. And a small rapport of interaction. How's the Josh? To just tell how exactly they feel about the website. And these are the details. So it has to be very simple. They can easily access it out. And that's the basic idea of this whole website. Yeah, it has to be elegant, simpler, and connecting the people with the highest priority. Thank you.
Hi, Subramania.
Yeah, hi.
Dude, amazing energy. I like the way you present your entire presentation. I like the energy and your confidence. Really good job there, you know. And so quick feedback on the design. Can you go to the first screen?
Yeah, second.
Yeah. So yeah, did you do the illustration? That's the first question. Did you do this illustration?
I mean, I didn't get you.
The illustration on the right, the hand image, did you design the illustration?
Yeah, I did it out. I mean, I had one hand. I just made it in rotations and did the whole
thing. I understand. That's amazing. That's good job, dude. That's great designing. And yes, again, I feel that here you have got it very personalized. I like the copywriting here, like by the students, for the students, and from the students. I like the way there was a refer for in the form, but I don't know what's the use of it. But as I'm just assuming that you guys need more people in this community, so you wanted to refer people. That's another good point. And apart from that, what I see is again the same issue on the visual design side. There's no correct hierarchy and the consistency part, right? So amazing job. I'm just giving a few feedbacks here. That is, see, for example, the login and join IEEE are really huge compared to home SCD and contact us. Right, and you see the join IEEE button is very bigger than login, right? So it's a little bit bigger. So that's a little bit inconsistent. And yeah, like also you see that student branch details, right? So what is SB details? Is it like student branch details?
Only? Student branch, because the text will be more. The thing is, since I'm using Canva, if I minimize the text more, you won't see the text at all. That's why I just made the navbar a bit heavy in its context. Or else it has to be very less in terms.
Hold on. Good job. Can you go to the next screen?
Yeah. This one, right?
Yeah. So this one you see here. So I think one thing is there's an accessibility issue. When I say accessibility issue, what is SCT is something which is not clearly visible to me, right? What is SCT? The white text on this blue background is something which is very hard to read for me. That's one thing which you have to note. Another thing is, there's something like you're pointing out to the next section, right? For example, what is SCT and learn more is there. And that card is pointing to the other card, right? I feel that it's pointing to the other card. Like that's what my, this thing is telling, right? So I feel that was not
one after the other.
Yeah. So I think That was not really necessary. You can just make it a small card and you could have given a good white space. That would be amazing. And you want to go to the next screen? Yeah, so even here, yeah, I see that register closed. Okay, similar thing. I think join Discord, I don't feel like it's a button, right? I feel it's just like a text there. You know, it could be like small, like underline kind of thing, like join us in, on Discord, and then it could be like underline below that, you know, and then people could have understood it's a link and then people could have clicked on that. So that's another thing. And Rush is okay, dude. It looks cool. I like the form what I've created. I like the form, like how what was like refer me and how was given. And then yes, what is Let's Connect? What's Let's Connect and what is LinkedIn ID, Instagram ID, Facebook ID?
I mean, because since it's about student coordination team, we already have all the details of the SP. The only details we don't have is their social media contacts.
All right. Like
whenever we do the events, we have this issue from the connecting, I mean, marking them in the Instagram or connecting them in the hashtags and all. So I think more than anything, this is an important thing what we are looking for as in terms of SET, if I'm not wrong.
Okay. Okay. No worries. I still feel it's really good. Like you see, that is what is strength of SB and what are you like chair of SB, XCOM member, we can even point out. So that's really nicely constructed. It's really nice. So again, I think could have improved the visual design, like the consistency, spacing and stuff like that. But apart from that, dude, I think the thinking here was really good and a good job, dude. That's it from my end. All the best, everyone. Yeah.
Hello.
Hi, Subramania.
Yeah, hi.
First of all, again, same thing, like really nice energy. I like the confidence. I like the jokes also that we had in between. Cool, I'll start with the feedback. So going back to the homepage.
Okay.
So over here, I actually, this is, first of all, this is really nice. The whole thought process also was nice. There are a few things that I can definitely point out, but it definitely comes with more experience. But it can help you in your it can help you in improving the design further. Is that let's say the pitch also that you have, right? The student coordination description pitch, that can be shorter. It doesn't have to be like 5 lines. Generally, if you keep it 2 lines, 3 lines, just try to. Just try to think that you don't really have the time to actually go through the entire thing, right? So this thing can be actually talked in the more, it can be spoken in a more detailed page or like one scroll down. There you can actually have like a further description, but generally like a few description is generally like better if you just keep it shorter because people generally don't have time, right? The other thing is that student branch details also, if you look at the alignment, like I see that you made it right alignment to student branch details, event details is left aligned. You can just keep both as left aligned because then it makes it more consistent. I understand from what idea you were coming from, like because this your you have this here, it'll look more united. But like actually, if you look at as a whole, right, you have like multiple elements as well, which is like the top student coordination team element, student details element. So along with that, it's better to keep it consistent with everything else. It's not only with event details, right? It's with the above one as well. So that is one feedback. Coming to the other feedback, also like there are multiple fonts also that is used in the homepage. You can just reduce it to 3, maximum 3. Like currently, if you look at it, the student coordination, this thing, an active group under IE, that has like a different font style. The fill out your student, the student branch detail subcopy has a different font style. And the by the students and the header has like a different font sizes to it. You can just, so it's generally like there's a rule also, like if you have like maximum of 3 font types that you should be able to work with it. So always work for the hierarchy, always work with the, instead of only working on the font sizes itself, work also with the font weights, which is like bold, medium, regular. And also work with the contrast of it also. That is what makes it, that is what gives it like the hierarchy. That is how you can play with the hierarchy of each font as well across on the screen. So contrast, font weight, and the font sizes. Generally better not to use too many different font sizes. Better to use more of a font weight type. That would help. Then in SCT, if you go there, what is SCT read events resources FAQ? If you like 0102, why do you have it like that? Like again, the question that Vaishnav had asked, you had put it like an arrow also. Was there a reason?
To just make it readability, because since more students are coming into the website, if we make it so plain, so dull, we may not get its joy of scrolling down. If it is something popping out, they may just look into it. And since I kept the text also very less, so I just wanted them to target on one and see the thing, two and see the thing. That was my thought when I was designing the thing.
Got it. Makes sense.
And just the arrow was like to see that you have to go there also. You can see there also, targeting like that.
Got it. Cool. Yeah. I mean, it's a good idea, good approach. This can be like, so. But the other thing also you might have to also look at is like, is it clear for the user? Like if you instead of using two, right, if you had used some sort of a book or some sort of a way illustration that actually conveyed the idea, because users not going to actually like, we are more inclined visually if you present something that connects with us faster than anything that you actually write or show in a different way. So if you had shown like illustration or some sort of a way, like what exactly the context of this is, read or events also, for example, it would have helped the user to actually go through it. And like, this is one approach of making the user actually go one by one, but you can explore more approaches as well, so that the readability and the thing that you want to convey also, right? The idea is nice that you want them to go through, like, first you want them to go through SCT, then you want them to go through read events. But I would suggest that this is not the only way. You can explore further regarding this. And learn more, read FAQ. Why is FAQ in green color, learn more, read in blue color?
Yeah, the FAQ, one thing was the color contrast, because all others are in the same color, the FAQ's background. The FAQ is something which pops up, because since we have forms to fill, we need to know what exactly the form. In the frequently asked question, we may have those questions also. So if it is popping out of all, they may go and see that also. What I thought of, like in FAQ also, we can give the review section and all. So that's one point where they can try to pop off. Oh, it has to stand out of everything.
Got it. Makes sense. It is standing out, actually. Like, it's standing out. Like, the intention is seen. Cool. Can you go to the next one? The contact us.
Okay.
Sorry. No. Whichever. Like, whichever one you want to show. Like, the previous page, okay. You can go to.
This one.
Yeah. So, over here. Okay. When I click on the events and I come here. Cool. So, again, like, as Vaishnav was mentioning, join us in Discord can be like a
button,
like a, make it seem like a button, because that's not obvious. Registered and closed, what do you mean by closed? Is it closed for me, or is it
I mean, the person who is entering the event has been done. I mean, I cannot register it furthermore.
Oh, so they've actually logged in, they've actually registered,
they know to log in also. That once I just come to the thing and just scroll down to events, if that event is open and they are able to register, it will show like register now and how many days are remaining for the registration.
And if the event is closed, then they can't do anything about it.
They can just click on it and further details can be done. Like if UI and X event is going on, they can go there and check the status and all, something like that.
Got it. Sure. Cool. Makes sense. One thing that you can do over here is also the fact that, okay, on the right, I see that you have like this, what do you call that? Paginator, like the vertical pagination.
Yeah, I mean, because there are lots of events going on, right? They can see the older events also.
Got it.
So like, there are some people, like personally me,
yeah,
who just goes to pages just to see their names or winning or something like that. There are people like that, because they just want to see their name in the winning chat or something like that. So for them also, they need the old events to be there.
Oh, like that. Got it. Makes sense. The thing that I would mention is that it's not, if you put it like horizontally instead of vertically, like it'll connect more intuitively with the person, because you have like a horizontal scroll, right, that you're doing. So over, instead of having the arrow also, just having, not having the arrow, just showing the event and just closing it gives the idea with the horizontal pagination that you can scroll further right. So that is one. Yeah, you can continue to explain. Yeah, over here, one thing that I would suggest is like student branch name, is it like a text field?
Yeah, it is text field.
Okay, so here, that's where my confusion is also, because now you have two types of text field, right? One is the student branch name, then there's like branch counselor name
actually,
as well.
Actually, one thing is, these texts right now, I just mentioned it. But once this person has been logged in,
yeah,
we will get all those details from the IEEE contact itself. It will be automatically filled. I haven't filled it, like I have mentioned my school name, college name.
Okay. Nice, nice. Yeah, the idea is nice. Yeah. So if I log in, then automatically this gets filled up, and if they want to edit it, they can edit it as well.
Yeah, exactly.
Correctly? Got it. Cool. Makes sense. So yeah. The UX makes sense. The other thing is also like, why do you have it like in two rows? Like, why is the branch counselor name on the right side? Why not just have it below?
Because since there is a constraint from the size of the whole website development, and even I think like if I don't use this like or make it so long or give lots of space, it won't be convenient when it converted to on mob web. So once we make it a partial half, then the mob web conversion will also be very flexible when converted to compared to other version. If you make it prolongly very long, they may not feel like filling it, because when the Google form is sent, we feel like we have to scroll down. There is lots of things to fill. You should just simply see, these are the simple things to be filled. I thought like that.
Okay, but when it comes to the mobile breakpoint, it'll anyways come down, is it?
Mobile, they have to come down. But at least if it is in this way, they'll feel like, okay, this much I have to fill, and they can do it quickly.
Got it. Cool. So here, one thing that you can do is like the consistency between the text field also, between the student branch name and the branch counselor name. These are two different text field. Like, why do you have two like different text field also?
I mean, one is just, as I said, one will be automatically filled. Another thing, they have to manually fill.
Oh, so student branch name is already filled. That's why you...
Yeah, those things will be already filled. The branch counselor name, these things are constantly changing due to different reasons.
Oh, okay.
They can fill it out accordingly.
Oh,
I thought of like...
Already done like that. Okay. Like, that is the state. All right. I think, yeah, then the placeholder should have... Like, that label should have just changed so that it would have been obvious also while looking at it. Otherwise, but yeah, the idea is good. Cool. And then just work on the alignment also. Like the radio button, you can just align it completely on the left instead of having a spacing. Like the circle with the choosing of the selection, you can have align it completely on the left. Also work on the spacing a little. The constraints, I understand. Okay, there was a constraint also. Cool. We can continue to the, okay, now here, refer to IEEE. Why has the button changed? Previously it was login and join, right?
Because once it is login, I don't need to mention again you have to log in. Once he has logged in, it is confirmed that he is IEEE member. And what best he can do for the IEEE to contribute along with filling these things is, he can refer other people to join IEEE. That's what SAT main intention is also, to connect more people into IEEE community. Mm-hmm. So I thought of giving that refer to IEEE. The text is wrong. I'm sorry for that.
No, it's fine. Maybe you can look at like probably placing it somewhere else, because what I already expected, right? And generally, because people come from other websites also, they already use other websites also. So you would generally see like, okay, login is here. Once I log in over here, my name is shown over on the top right. So that's what I would expect. But then I'll refer to IEEE. Okay, how do I go to my account? Now you will have something like a my account also, right? Generally, I would
expect. It will be directly login, because he has to log in credential from the IEEE main server itself. So it won't be an issue. It will redirect him to the referring page or download, give him a downloaded PDF of refer contact, something like that.
Okay.
That's pre IEEE things. I mean, I'm not pretty sure of it, but I thought like that, so they can refer more people regarding IEEE.
No, I got like they have the contact details. The login contact details will be there with the IEEE. I understand all that. I'm asking like, is there like a my account section also that IEEE has?
Yeah, it has.
So that is what I would expect on the top right? Like generally.
But we can't show it in our website, because there is a different website for them. Anything they have to see, they have to go there only.
Okay, got it. Cool, sure. So it's why, okay, I'm just trying to understand the context a little better. Like, why is there two different websites like this?
I mean, it's IEEE things.
It's like the larger organization. This is like the Bangalore section. Got it.
Yes, exactly.
Okay, cool. Let's continue. Yeah, so over here on the right side, again, I'm seeing that vertical pagination. Why is that? So that takes me back to the events, is it? Like, as
yeah,
I...
exactly. They can just go back to the things.
Oh, like that.
I thought of doing like that to just make it more comfortable since we have the size constraint.
No, but now because I came to events from SCT and then I was seeing the vertical pagination.
That might feel like order.
No, it's because it's coming out of the IA, right? Like it's not part of, it's not inside the page. And it's like that's the confusion that can happen.
I mean, it is there also here, but pop-ups more here.
No, so it's there over there also, but it makes sense because it comes under SCT.
Yeah.
Once I'm in SCT, then I have like five more different, five entry points, which is within the SCT page. But this is in the contact us page. Like you have it in the homepage also, this one vertical page.
Yeah, I have it.
Okay. Okay. Cool. So SCT has few more steps. That's all.
Yeah, that's it.
Okay, cool. Makes sense. Cool, yeah, great job. This is really nice work. I like how you thought about it, and I like the depth in which you've thought about it also. So visual design, yeah, it can definitely improve, but like the hierarchy as mentioned previously, right? Hierarchy, spacing, few stuff, contrast, like even the SCT, the contrast can be done better, but otherwise, great job.
Thank you.
Hey Subramanian.
Yeah, hi.
I really like the illustrations and animations you have used, so great job with that.
Thank you.
And IEEE is, I think, original logo you have used, so good thought. Let's start with from the homepage, yeah.
One second. Yeah.
So one thing I feel here when I land here is a lot of things are happening, right? There's this big description. Then you have learn more, SB details, event details. All the buttons are taking equal attention, but then I don't know what you want me to look at first, right? What should be more important for me? You're leaving it to the user to decide what you want to, you know, go ahead with.
Well, I think I did it only because of one reason. That is, this page is like once, as they mentioned in the documentation also, it has the landing page has to emphasize also more about those forms which has to be filled. So that's why I kept some more weight on these things, or else it can be minimized, of course.
Has to give details about what forms?
Those two forms which has to be filled.
Achha, okay. Yeah, but then maybe, you know, we can make them into cards or something different so that not everything is at an equal level for the user. Here, learn more SB details and event pages. Event details are popping out equally, right? And then I also have login and join IEEE. So it's like as a user, I have a lot of options to take an action on. So my cognitive load is so high because I need to decide.
Oh.
So, you know, that way maybe you can just put in a hierarchy, although the forms can also take attention, but maybe not equal attention. Then again, as Vaishnav mentioned, amazing job with the illustration. Another thing here is, again, I think your navigation bar ka font size is a bit bigger as it is supposed to be, and login and JE again are even bigger than that. Let's move to the, and I think the description is too long when I'm landing here because it's like five lines. Although when I land here, I just want my eyes to move to know what it is about, and then I can move ahead. I'm not going to spend like 30 seconds to, you know, go through it because it tells me student coordination team, so I can guess that okay, it is something about them. You know, maybe it can be short, like one or two liners, so that the user reads it. As you mentioned in the form, that the user be like, "Bahut lamba form hai, kaun padega?" Could be similar here, yaar. Itna sara kaun padega?
Got it.
Yeah. Let's move ahead. Here again, I think so many colors are used, and major problem I feel here is the CTAs again, learn more, read events are taking more attention than the title or subtitle. You want the user to read first what is SCT and then the subheader just So here the problem is subheader also talks about the action. Learn more, take a deep dive into SCT. But maybe, you know, you can utilize this space to give a brief introduction about what SCT is, right? Because you're already saying SCT, learn more. So you can take them there. Here subhead and your CT are doing the same job. So maybe you can think about that. And I think your subheading ka font weight for section one is different from all other four. So maybe you want to keep it consistent. Maybe take a deep dive is regular, but others are medium or semi.
Actually, I made it bold, but some Canva restrictions. Like,
could be, yeah.
At the design I made and it's popping now, it's quite different.
Okay. And also, I think your CTAs are too big. Here you can see even your CTA is much, much bigger than your title.
Yeah.
But ideally, it is not supposed to be, because title should be taking my attention first, because that is going to put me into a thought. Okay, so what is SCT? Let's learn about it. If you're directly telling me learn more about what, you know. So first grab the attention and then you can push the user to take an action. I think also, and here again, you just tell me the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 per header. I'm getting no information about anything on the last page, right?
But okay, I mean, I thought of like just making them interactive with that.
Even to interact, you need to, you know, first get their attention here. Otherwise, I'll just move ahead. I'm like, okay, kuch kuch likha hai, but I don't know. If you just drop in one line about each of them, that can, you know, that can make me want to learn more about the section. I'm gonna take an action on it. Yeah.
I'll try to give animations next time.
Yeah. Awesome. Next up is.
Yeah, this one.
I like all the images you have used. So number one is, there are a lot of times you've used the IEEE logo on each tile. Is that for any specific reason?
I mean, to just mention the, give the trademark of IEEE. Just keep it more simple.
Maybe because the page also belongs to IEEE, so you can think if you again want to use it, and if yes, then how many? Matlab, here it's like three, four times on each tile you have used, right?
I kept and it then, almost everywhere.
Sorry?
I kept it everywhere to this.
Right. And these icons, I think, again, are too big. You know, it's taking as equal attention as the image of the thumbnail. So maybe, you know, you might want to think if you want this to be this big, the lock icon, the closed and the register thing, because the text is too small as compared to the size of your logo. And I feel even the circles are maybe inconsistent, the locks.
I just made it to ensure that event is open or not, to make a clear picture about it. I thought like that.
And then your subtitle, which says challenge running in the second one, but in the third one, it says winners announced, right? So both of them are supposed to be at the same hierarchy, but you have used different font styles for them. Because at the first place, I felt ki third ka subtitle is missing. Then I read and I realized, okay, the font style is different. So, you know, these are the minor things, but yeah, for the user, it helps them move ahead in the possible direction. And again, Mockstream 2.0, do you want the user to know first about the event or just 3 days left? Because 3 days is taking the most attention there.
Yeah, registering is important. Then once he enters into it, he will get more information about it.
Right. So here, even the register icon is taking my attention and the 3 days text, right? And not the name of the event. Because that is a bit smaller.
I was just thinking about emphasizing more about it's running, happen? Days are running now, something like that.
Right. Yeah, so maybe, you know, instead of icon, this lock icon, you can use the timer or something, you know, so that it serves both the purpose. And then again, if you are giving the arrow, which tells you to move on the right, so arrow again has a background and then it has a white tile. So again, because if you can, you might want to think if you want so many elements to be used, right? If you remove that, maybe it will give you more white space and, you know, the user can focus on the right things.
I was thinking like almost has scrolled to some bit. I just wanted to give that feel.
Right. So the green icon, the arrows in the green circle are telling me, right, that it's a tappable icon, tappable element. So again, giving the white tile I mean, maybe you want to think about it. Yeah.
Whitetail is it's also another event, but it's partially open, something like that. I mean, once you're scrolling in such events, you'll feel like that, no?
Achha, so that tile will only move. Got it. So in that case, maybe the right corners of that tile, you want to keep them sharp to tell that it's a half tile, right? Right now, because all the corners are rounded, it gives me the feeling that it's a full tile in itself. So I felt that. So maybe you can do that.
Yeah, I have to keep an eye on it.
Yeah. Yeah, let's move ahead. For the form, I feel your student branch name, which is your input text, is as compared to your underline is not standing that. Matlab, this underline feels like a progress bar to me because it's too strong. And I think your opacity of the text is a little on the lower side. So the emphasis is being taken by the progress bar, which is the underline and not the input field. So maybe you want to think about that. And also not because the underline is too high. It's too wide actually. And then again, let's connect while it's somewhere in the center. I'm not getting the hierarchy right. Because maybe if I understand that you have the constraint for space, but then maybe these checkboxes, you can put in two columns so that you get enough space for let's connecting. Because right now it's somewhere in the center. I can move from top to bottom and left to right. And as others also rightly pointed out, using two very different input fields again might confuse the users because it might feel like these are two different forms or these are supposed to serve some different purpose.
No, yeah, but these are, pre-filled and these are has to be filled. I thought like that. Maybe
you can play around color for the same input fields or opacity to figure that out. That, okay, this is pre-filled and uneditable and this is you have to fill in.
Yeah.
You can
look into it.
And again, your submit button here, which is a CTA, and your inputs on the right are of the same visual style. So I'm not able to bifurcate that, okay, this is what is allowing me to take an action versus this is an input field. What's this upload ke niche cross code?
He has to upload a file about the event.
No, what does this cross coding signify?
It's telling which file he has uploaded.
Acha, okay. And why? Cross
is to delete. If he want to upload another file, he can just put on the cross and upload again.
Okay. Because right now here it feels like cross is an icon for the coding.
Once it's uploaded, because many people who upload, they won't understand. Sometimes they may upload another file.
Right.
So if they upload, if the name is present, they can reconfigure it. I thought like that.
Yeah, but the cross is taking too much attention, because of the size and weight used. So maybe you can look into that.
That's it.
Any reason why here the mail is in caps on?
I just took it from the main Bangalore section, just to emphasize, I think. It has to be in small letter, but I took it there directly from there.
Okay, cool. Got it. I really like this emoji wala thing, how's the Josh? Although how's the Josh is too small, so maybe you can give more emphasis. But great idea.
Thank you.
Awesome, man. All the best. That's it.
Thank you.
Okay, so thank you, Subramanya. So the next participant is Monisha. Are you there, Monisha?
Hello, hi. I am here.
Yeah.
Is my screen visible?
Not
yet.
Give me a second. It's loading. Sorry. It's loading. I'm sorry.
No worries, no worries. It's okay.
Is it visible now?
Yes, yes, it is.
Okay. This is Monisha. I have used mainly three colors, that is blue, gray, and combinations of white, black. Because in most corporate sites, these combinations of colors are used because of the trust, and it depicts the trust. That color depicts the trust. Hence, I use those colors. And coming to the icons which I have used, I use the search icon in the leftmost side because we start like humans always start like we start reading from left to right, hence it will be easier for the person whoever is in hurry or whatever his mindset is, he can go automatically and search whatever field he is required and he can get the information. And this is the home page of the website. I wanted it to be simple because the only those images will be swiping like of the previous events. And this is the home page, and here the upcoming events details will be there. Just a small note of it. Now, next is about us page. In this, I have given a small description about the SCT because I know people will not be more interested in reading about the thing. So I have given the main points which are required on the about us screen. And if they are interested, they can go to the option for the read mode and they can access to the more information. And like people will be interested about the team who is running this whatever the institute or thing. So I have given the images of them. If you click on the images, you will get detailed information about it, about that particular person. And anything related to the related questions about the institution, you will find in FAQ. And if is not, he or she is not a member, they can become a member. If they are already a member, they can log in. Till they don't want to like log into the page until they know about what actually is the page is. So the next page is the details. This is the form they have to fill in order to submit the whatever details they are having. So they mentioned about the two forms, that is details about student branch and the event report details. I assume that after entering their student branch details and if that gets verified, they can enter the event name, whatever they have performed. So this is how that looks. So I use this upload file and things. And next comes the event page. Like what I thought is the upcoming program can be specified in a bigger thing because like they can easily access, it will be easily accessible for the user to get the information. And then likewise, the next upcoming events. So here is the event details and the coordinators they can like contact or anything they can do. So next comes the contact us page, and this is the like end footer. And here they have any like if they have to send their message or any feedback or anything related to the institute, they can easily write us instead of going to the like instead of taking the numbers or anything, they can directly message or send anything, any kind of information to us. So I gave this small message box, and I have like mentioned all the headers in each and every page, because if by chance if you are in about page and you need to go to the home page, so you can easily travel or navigate between those pages. So this is how I have used. And even when you are in last end of the website, if you want to go to the event section and visit it, you can visit it. So I made this kind of changes. And here is the login thing. When you're logged in, your like first letter of your name will be displayed. So this is about the thing. And I have used a single font, that is Ego, that it is used by Microsoft. So it was more readability. So I used this font. Yeah, this is all about my website.
Good job, Monisha. I think it looks good. At least I like the hierarchy, at least in the first thing, because I see that there's a home about us and details in the top. And then I feel that there's a lot of usage of IEEE logo, like because see, as so when I come down, right, I don't want to see like a lot of logos, because that's not really actionable, right? Because that's not,
yes,
really, it's not really creating a value, right? I want to see events in the top page, right? So those things you need to keep in your mind, like giving more into the UX perspective. When I come down to this website, I want to see events, or I want to see what this is page is all about, right? Rather than a lot of images and you know, just the logos. That's one thing you need to keep in mind. But I like the whole layout and stuff like that. And quick question, why is it vertical and not horizontal scroll? So I just want to understand something. Look, when you do you scroll the website like horizontally or vertically?
Horizontally. I didn't want the users to I wanted them to use only those keys to move horizontally. I didn't want that scroll button. So I just made a little change.
Okay.
Yes.
It's a little bit of mental model of a user, but it's okay. It's fine. I think. Yeah, that's it. And other thing is, again, similar things, what I want to give the feedback for the entire thing is, one thing on the contact, you could have made it more consistent, right? All the text fields on the one side, and all the subheadings on the other side, all the labels on the one side, all the, you know, form like text fields on the other one. It could be consistent in the contact form kind of a thing. And other thing is, I see there's a lot of translucent backgrounds. For example, like you see here, right? Like a glass kind of a thing. So that is good. But again, you see the background, right? Background is more attracting than the foreground, right? So I want it to be, it could be, background could be like white color or black color, where it's not really attracting me. So the background is so attracting for me, like you know, the blue color thing on the background is really attracting my eye, right? But I don't want to focus on that. I want to focus on the text, right? So these are the small things you need to focus on, right? And rest of the thing is really good, dude. I like the layout, I like everything, and yeah, all the best, Manisha. Good job.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much.
Yep.
Hey, Monisha.
Hello.
Yeah. Hey, nice job. Nice job with the way you explained the reasoning behind your design. I liked it.
Thank you.
The homepage, coming to the homepage, as I was mentioning, like logo can be like just a, it can just, you don't have to overuse the logo. So that's one.
Okay.
Second, the search also, like, think about this also, like, so there's, don't reinvent the wheel. Yeah, there's like already there's a mental model that exists. So for search, it's always on the top right. People would generally look at.
Okay.
So you can talk to that on the top right. And coming to the blue part of the color, I understand that it's about the trust, right? That you're basically used to blue color. But along with that, the way it's used also, the blue color is used also, right? You have to look at, like, for example, here, there's a lot of edges also the background has for the blue color. Is that really building trust? It seems a little sci-fi in that sense as well. So for that, you maybe use it in a different way. So that's the third one. Then also, I just wanted to understand, like, what do you expect the user, for example, what do you expect the user to come to the site for?
site for they can log in or for the events, what events are taking place, to know about the details about the events or to submit the information they have got from the from an event.
Got it. No, so like as soon as the person lands on the page, okay, so what is the most important thing for you to for the user to do over here, like as soon as they came come to the page according to you?
To know which page they have landed in.
Okay. Cool. Yeah. So, cool. So there are like how like this sessions also what I'm seeing is that there are three types of users that you guys are targeting. One is like someone you just want them to mm-hmm. sign in so that it's easier for them to submit the student form. Second is like let them know like yeah. what the events. And third is basically third is if someone new is coming, you probably want to tell them like what this thing is about as well. So one mm-hmm. depending on that, if it was the second and the first one, I would also show the this thing upfront, which is like basically if I'm coming for submitting the form mm-hmm. or log, then I'll just keep it upfront and just there has to be some sort of a CTA, whatever is the most important action that needs to be taken, because upcoming event is probably not the most important. This is more like a general thing that everyone, it's good for everyone, but which is fine, you can keep that, but like you need to think from the angle of like is this the only most important action over here, or is there something else as well? If this is the most important, then this works. Monisha, like if I understand it correctly.
Okay.
Then then can you just go to the contact page once?
Yes. Is it visible?
No, it's not coming. I'm still on the home page.
I have changed it.
Is this only an issue with me, or can anyone else also not see that?
I can't see.
I that. Guess my network is less.
No, I can.
Low.
No issues.
Yeah.
Okay, got it. Cool. So yeah, just look at the button types also. There's you can keep like a consistency between the buttons that you're using across the web pages. That is something. So here, okay. send is different. Over there, sign in is different. Basically. There's like a circular button over there, it's a rectangle button. So just look at that angle as well. Also just look into like more of the type of text fields also that you can have on the contact page.
Okay.
This might not be the best mm-hmm. approach. That's like you can you don't have to keep it like a separate mm-hmm. thing on the left mm-hmm. side only. You can just make combine okay. it with the text field itself. Message okay. is fine. Can you just go to the go to the about us. Yeah, about us was fine, was good. Events page.
Events page. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
Is it visible?
No, not right now.
No.
Got it. Just wanted to understand, like, okay, so one thing that you mentioned was like whatever is the most important, like most recent one, that one you want to bring mm-hmm. it up front, right? That's why the top part
yes.
you've figured out from the rest of it. Yeah, good approach.
Yes, yes.
The second thing is like I wanted to understand is that if there are more events, like further events, like more than two or three events, like how does that get shown up over here?
Yeah. Actually, for that, in this event page, we have to scroll down because of the constraint. I didn't do that.
Okay.
Like,
got it.
It will, or is vertically it will be.
No, that's fine. I don't want to, like, basically, I understand that basically it'll scroll down and that's how you can see it. So, here are the coordinators. Is
yes.
it different from speakers?
Yes, coordinators are different from speakers. Like they'll support the event and speakers are different.
So that's something that would I want to know who the coordinators are, or would I want to know who the speaker is for the event?
Okay,
I mean,
I understood.
So yeah, but yeah, there's date, there's time, there's, I understand there's like what the mm-hmm. a certain competition. And yeah, so the button thing itself, just keep it consistent. That's what, again, the feedback would be.
Okay. Thank you.
Just capital letters also. Just see, like, is it necessary? Why use capital letters? Why not just go with title case or a small case, sentence case itself? That would work better. So, for example, yeah. So there's one more thing. So there's prominence. I understand there's importance of elements also, right? But at the same time, it's not like you can't make everything very important. You'll have to see it as a story, like what exactly you want to put. And then you create some sort of an expectation in the user's mind. And then the register now button, instead of having a register now button, it can be just with an arrow as well. So because the user already expects that this is a button. So that approach is something that you can look at and just see like how that can be worked over here as well. Other than that, like that looks good, Monisha. Like, great job.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Hello. Hi. Sorry, I can't hear you.
Let's go to page one.
Okay. Is it
so I really like the color, some of the images that you have used. Good choice. So here again, the most attention, the element that is getting is the image, but I assume that's, that shouldn't be the case because I think this image is not related to the event, right? That is coming in the script.
It's not related to the event.
Right. So that is taking a lot of attention and I'm gonna might going to relate the image with the event in some way. This message that you get on the gray strip is also scrollable. Does it change?
Yeah, it keeps changing. Like automatically. Depending on
along with the image.
Yes.
Cool. So maybe you can see if you want to, you know, maybe give more attention to the event than the imagery in some way.
Okay, sure.
And this search button, I feel, is a little lost in the background. It is, I mean, until the moment you mentioned that there's a search button, I almost missed it.
Okay.
Because, you know, a lot of darker shades and bright colors are being used, so that search is not taking the attention. And the sign-in button, I feel, is a little squeezed because the text of the sign-in button is smaller than the other font sizes. So ideally, you know, all of them should be consistent.
Okay.
Let's go ahead. So here, as you mentioned, our team, maybe with the name, you also want to mention what their designation is, right? What role they are playing? Because, I mean, maybe just looking at the names might not be useful for me because I might not know everyone, right? So in that way, what role they are playing? And these buttons, maybe because again, your title, your subtitle, all of them are wrapped in a gray button. And again, your CTAs are also wrapped in the same visual element, right? Become a member, already a member. So they're not serving as the CTAs because a lot of same elements are found in the screen, right? You might want to think about how to make the CTAs stand out so that the user can know that they're actually oriented.
Okay.
Yeah, let's move on.
Yeah.
There again, you might want to, you know, see if the input boxes should be aligned with each other. Here, the top three are not aligned to the bottom three. So, you know, it gets into the zigzag pattern, but if they are aligned, they would be more cleaner and easier for the user. So then you can think about it. I think again, on all your pages, the CTA pattern is changing, right? On the last page, it was a gray button with no, it was a sharp edges, right? And it's the rounded corners mm-hmm. with a different colored CTS. Again, it might confuse the user. So to maintain hierarchy, okay. you can keep all of them similar.
Okay.
Next up.
Yes.
Yeah. So here the information in the white box and the below that are different. Are those are two different events?
Those are two different events. These are.
So again, I think that's intentional that your mock stream wala box is not aligned to the digital conference because of the pattern you have used.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And again, the CTAs are, we were going to the gray CTAs, then peach, then green, then blue. So a lot of different colors are used. Maybe you want to restrict that.
Okay.
Overall, I like this white box wala pattern and layout. It's quite clean and gives me the right information. Any mm-hmm. reason that you have used uppercase throughout?
No, I thought it will be easily read by the user. It will reach their eyes soon. So I thought like that.
Because, now when it's in bigger size, it's easier to read. But when now, your mock stream can each October 16, 10 a.m., it's smaller size and even the font weight is higher, which is, let's say, bold or bold, right? So then it gets difficult for the user to read. Or senior product designer, ad designer, when those are longer sentences, uppercases are not that easy to read.
Okay.
So maybe we can think about it.
Not that.
What's next? Here again, I think the text contact as well, all the image, all the text is sort of blending with the background image and it's not too readable. IEEE Bangalore, if you see, so it's not that readable. Again, you can think about giving some gradient or a layover on the image to make it clear.
Okay.
Any reason why the navigation bar here is in the bottom and on the other pages it's on the top?
No, because we reached to the end of the website, so I thought it will be easier if it is down. It will convey them. It is end of the website.
The user is scrolling horizontally, right? So maybe he do not have he is not into that mental. When he is scrolling vertically, you realize that this is the end.
Uh-huh.
But here, the top and bottom thing might not. Yeah.
Okay.
Overall, great job. I like the imagery.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. Thanks.
Thank you. The next participant is Shivani. I just got a PDF. I will just share the screen. The judges can just see it. PDF.
Reading out her report, which she sent to the organizers on her behalf, she is not able to join the meeting today due to technical issues. So I'll start reading. My design layout is simple. I've chosen the light peach, orange, and white color as they give aesthetic look, and nowadays people prefer aesthetic looks. The layout is set in such a way that a user can scroll through it and understand what to do next. The event schedule is provided in one section to show that it's the same type of data, and the testimonials help the user make a better decision. The registration form is to the right as it catches the user's attention. The Z format. I've used several references to see how people align forms, and most of the big names like Facebook, Stripe, and others have a similar format. This is her report.
Is this Shivani's presentation?
Yes.
Cool.
So are you done presenting?
Actually, she's
She's
not.
not here in this meeting, but yeah, this was her report.
Okay, cool, dude. Like, basically, if she's not here, we don't have to give any feedback, right? We'll just put the marks here and we'll move on to the next participant. Cool?
Yep.
Yeah, awesome.
Okay, so our next participant is Deeksha.
Good evening to all the judges. One minute, I'll share my screen. Is my screen visible?
No leaks, so it's not visible.
Okay, now?
Nowadays, yeah.
Oh yeah, cool. This is the home landing page. It's very basic. I've used blue color throughout, and I've used same font, like one single font for all the four pages. The reason for using blue color is, again, it's related to trust and all. So I've used blue color, and also the IEEE logo has blue. So yeah. So this is the landing page. I'll present. One minute. So this is the nav bar, and it has five components. The first, this is the landing page, and the next is the data portal. Here we have two forms, that is the student branch details and event report details. Once the user fills all this form, both of these form and logins, then he or she will be able to submit the form. I haven't created a separate login page because it was mentioned that four pages are enough. And this is the footer, which, again, the header and the footer is the same throughout. This is the events page. This just shows the upcoming events that are going to be held. And this is the contact us page. It includes the basic details, and when the person fills in all the details and clicks on submit, the IEEE team will reach back to them. So I created this keeping that in mind. That's all. That's all I have to tell.
Good, Diksha. Yeah, like I really like the minimalism of the design. Like you've used very minimal colors. So is there any reason why you use very minimal colors, like only blue? Like you didn't try to use any other color. Like I see there is grays and stuff like that, but why is it so monochromatic? Any reason?
I just wanted to keep it simple and pretty basic. There's no other reason as such.
Okay.
I thought, okay.
Yeah, sounds good though. Like, see, I like it because it's very minimalistic and it's very small. So, and there's a lot of white space here, right? So I can easily, you're guiding my eye to read what's first and what's second. So that's something which I
Exactly.
like. Yeah, that's really good, right? But at the same time, maybe you could have made more personalized, right? So when I come onto the website, so a lot of users don't read, So picture speaks more words, right? So you could have used more pictures, for example, upcoming events, right? So it's so hard for me to read 7th October IEEE International Conference system, but in one image you could have already delivered everything, right? It could be a small image related to the international conference or something. It could be more personalized, right? So you could have used a little bit of more images. It would be awesome, right? But I really like the design though. So what's the image on the right?
So this is for the visual appeal. Since IEEE stands for international, it includes all the engineering fields. So I thought let's include all the fields and then make a collage and then just put it at the side.
Very cool idea, but maybe you could have made that scrollable images, right? Like there's scrollable images, like one by one keeps coming on the websites. Have you noticed them?
Got it. Got it. Like a carousel.
Exactly, like a carousel. Yeah. So I could have done that, but yeah, it's okay. Like it's still a good design. And something like SB data portal, right? You see, you read that, it sounds, for example, I know you're making it for students, but let's say somebody who's in first year and is going to come down here, he doesn't understand what portal and all is. Maybe we could have made a little bit more simplified, but yeah, I'm just giving whatever, I'm just thinking out loud what could be better. And do you want to go to the next slides? Maybe? Yeah. So even this one looks cool to me though. Like, yeah, it's very small and minimalistic. I kind of like this, but yeah, like, see, one thing is, I don't know where to enter. Where's the text field here, right? For example, there's name and it's not consistency. For example, from phone number to the line bottom would be the different spacing between from the name to the other line there. So the spacing, those small, small things you need to keep it in your mind. But apart from that, yeah, it looks cool, dude. Yeah, upload button is there, attached document. Cool. And anything else? Can you go to the next slides? Yeah, same. I think, you know, it's really cool. But at the same time, a little bit of images would have made a really good job here. But yeah. Do you want to go to contact us page?
Yeah.
So even here, the text field is not consistent. Like the what we have seen there in the previous slide, the text field is different from this. But I understand that you could have kept it consistent. That's one feedback. And second thing is, there's something called minimum tappable area, right? For example, let's say I have a small finger. Somebody would have very big finger. So there's a universal pixel for that. Like it's 44 into 44 pixels for something, or 38 into 38 pixels. So for me, I feel that this is very small. Right, somebody who has very huge hands would tap on two different it's not an app. I think you don't have to worry about it. True. I understand, dude. I think it's cool, dude. Yeah, and you see that the select one has a very small this thing. Maybe you could have made it a little bit more bigger, the button there. But yeah, looks good, dude. Good job.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Hey Deeksha.
Hi. I'll go back to the first.
Yeah, so it's I'll start with the feedback. So as Vaishnav was mentioning, right, the images can be there for upcoming events and all. Like you can have like images for that. And first of all, like great job. Like this is like really well put. Just like the hierarchy is there, so like the if I come to this page, right, I understand, okay, this is where upcoming events is, this is testimonials, and then everything is very clear that way. But now you can make it more visual. You don't have to just make the user read through it. You can make it more obvious as well. So, and the other thing is also that you don't need like double bullet points, right? You can just have like a single bullet point for like a single event. So that is one, and have images also, testimonials also. So basically just the image thing, and for the right side image also just have the carousel. Otherwise the page works. Also just look at the two line part for the SP data portal. Better to have it as one line just so it's consistent.
Yeah.
On the copy or something. Otherwise, yeah, this page looks great. Why do you have the dotted line at the bottom?
That was actually the footer. There's no reason as such.
Okay. No, is it like a design element that you felt like would make it look better?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, cool. No issues. Yeah, makes sense. Can we go to the next pages? Okay. Also, one more feedback. Like if you can also use, if you're trying to use a separator, right, the background itself for the footer was enough. But if you wanted to use any other separator as well, you can also use like a separator that's like very that has like a very less opacity to it, like a 10% line, or a very less contrast to it with the background that is behind it.
Yeah.
For example, it's just white, right? You can just increase it by a little to make it move it towards the darker side, or you can just and you can also play with the dotted over there also. But so there are like different ways of approaching the separator. You can just explore that. And yeah, coming to this page, basically, how do I, so click here to log in and submit. Okay, so first I'll have to log in over. So after I've entered the details, right, for student branch
Yeah.
details, can I log in and submit, or
Then
should I?
log in. Yeah. Then log in, and then you get a page which will allow you to submit.
Will it come back to this page, or will it take me to a different page and ask me like, do you want to submit it now?
Yeah, that's a separate page. I did not create that page.
Okay, that's fine. So, and do I have to fill the event report details also over here, or can I do it without the event report details?
Here, since it was mentioned that two forms should be there and it should be filled, so I thought like maybe once you enter all the details and then once you log in, you get the place there to submit. I was a little confused with this.
That's fine. Like login and that submit works. I want to understand like right now either event report details is something that I have to fill, or like without that filling, so can I just I don't think that's possible, right? I just entering the student branch details is that enough?
No. You have to fill both these and then you can submit.
Got it. So yeah, just look at that also. Just the you can probably bring them closer. It's all right to have white space on the left and right, but you have to combine it together and make it seem like these are part of the same form only. Otherwise, it still feels like this is a student branch is like one form that I have to fill, and then I can log in and submit event report. I don't have to do anything also because it's so far away, right?
Yeah. So, okay, got it.
Yeah. So some way to unite it together and then have like a final button that makes it seem like, okay, this is for both the forms. So that. Mm-hmm. And then can you go to the about and events, like about, just go to the next page. Yeah, so same feedback as Vaishnav, the images you can add, you can add time also over here. I think there's nothing else. Yep, this looks good. Otherwise, the whole, the way you separated it also and arranged it in a layout manner, it works. And can you go to the contact us page? Yeah, so for now, as Vaishnav was saying, right, like the text field area is like there's a minimal tappable area, but even on desktop as well, like there's something like you can see the how much difference is there between the first name and the text field. So if the label is itself is so big, text field is so small, whereas the text field, the input that you're adding should actually be like given more importance, right? Whereas here it seems the label is being given more importance. And so that is something you can look at. Also, like text field, I think currently you can increase the size for that. Just or is it to me that it's looking smaller because it's like placed next to the such a big font size? So probably just look into just make it seem like that the label, like basically the label is not given more importance than the input that you're actually adding inside it. Like, or like, it can be given importance, but there can be like a different ways of approaching it as well. So like just look into how text fields like can be combined with label, so that that way you won't you'll have like just a it'll look more connected as well, because it'll only be like one single text field with the label inside it, or it might be outside it also. So it'll look better as well. And you can also center align this. Like currently I see that it's a little left aligned, it's moving a little away from the center, so that is one thing, but otherwise it looks good. Yeah, mainly because contact information, and when you are, so the contact information is going outside the border, right? If you look at the
okay, so I had to place this below the contact information. Yeah, okay, I get it.
Got it. And the submit can also be along the same line itself. Like it can be, imagine it always like a box, right? That way it's easier to like for the people to also scan through the whole form as well. Otherwise, if something is placed here, contact, not talking about the contact information, I'm talking about the submit. But I guess submit was also supposed to be below the text field.
Yeah, okay, misplaced it.
Okay, that's fine. So select one as well, the country or region that you can have, because it's select one, right? It'll be better if you have like a triangle icon, a drop down icon, so that it's that you can do. Otherwise, also the red color, you don't have to make it red in color. Just the you can use the same color. That's more than enough to actually give the idea that you have to enter this field?
Okay, I was not sure about that. Everywhere I've seen red color, so I thought.
Yeah. I know. I've seen it, but that's not necessary.
Okay.
Cool. Yeah, that's it. Otherwise, great job, Disha. Hope the feedback was useful and
Thank you so much.
Am I audible now?
Yeah.
Hey, Diksha.
Hi.
Let's move to page one. I'm really surprised how everyone has used so much of blue. So good job.
Thank you.
That seems like a additional unsaid rule now that everyone has to use blue. Cool. So overall, I like it. The only thing is the way you have used the typography and, you know, how clean it is. I really like it. The point is it's a little too text heavy. So as others also pointed out, it might not be, you know, the user might not be so interested in reading each bit of it. So you can use imagery or illustrations, you know, to support the content a bit. Then any reason why, so this thing is really taking my attention, SB data portal is into two lines in the navigation bar. Did you try adjusting it into one?
I tried, it was not coming. So I know it looks a little weird. Oh, I should have made it into a single line.
Maybe, you know, because your text size for the navigation bar is too big, it's even bigger than your titles here, IEEE SCT, which is, I mean, navigation bar doesn't need that much attention. So, you know, you can again play around with the size and make it smaller so that all of them adjust in one line.
Yeah, I look into it.
Yeah, I really like how monochromatic colors you have used. But again, here on the, you know, homepage, you have given me the intro about IEEE SCT, then upcoming events, testimonials. So a lot is happening, right? Do you want me to first know about the upcoming events or testimonial or SCT? Because I cannot know about everything at once. So just because I have too many options to look at, I might end up looking at nothing. So that's one thing.
Okay.
And here again, I feel 17th October is your first event, then 23rd October. Still, you have used different text sizes for some reason, and I assume it is supposed to be consistent. So, any reason for that?
Yeah, it was supposed to be consistent. I didn't.
Okay. Cool. And also, so for the testimonials, you have written the name. So again, you know, you may want to think if everything should be left aligned, because here again, it's going, I mean, it's a bit inconsistent.
Okay.
And your click here is not taking, again, upcoming events and testimonials are taking more attention than click here. So the CT, I feel, is getting a little lost.
Mm-hmm.
I really need to read the entire thing to know that, okay, the CT exists. So. Yeah, maybe you want to put it into a container like a traditional CT or something.
Okay.
Yeah, let's move ahead. As the others rightly pointed out, this seems like two different forms to me, but click here to log in and submit goes only for the first one, so it's a bit confusing. And again, I think the spacing between the label and the space, the input field you have, is too less. So where am I going to write my name, right? The space is too less, there are no placeholders. So, and again, I think you have used just the text for all your CTAs. Maybe you want to think, because this is a primary CTA, right? So maybe you want to put it into a container so that it takes enough attention and it's, you know, it's the user is not missing out on it.
Yeah.
And here again, your student branch data submission, which is your heading, and then both your subheadings, all of them are of the same size and same visual styling. So each of them is taking the same attention and there's no hierarchy, I feel, because, I mean, that's one title and two subtitles. So there is supposed to be some hierarchy. You can think about it.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Let's move ahead. Yeah, I mean, here you can just, you know, use some imagery or illustrations to support this. Otherwise, it's all good to go.
Okay.
Yeah, let's move on. Same, suddenly now coming on this page, the, you know, text sizes have increased a little, right? Abhita, you were using, the text sizes were slightly on the lower font size, but here it's suddenly everything is a lot popping out. So, and it's, oh, yeah. I think it's a bit misaligned also. It's not center aligned, so you can think about it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay.
All the best.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for it.
Guys, who's next?
Pranav here. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yeah, can I share?
Go ahead, man.
Okay, just a minute. Yeah, is my screen visible?
Yes, we can see.
Okay, yeah, thank you. So yeah, I have approached a very minimalistic design, and yeah, I'm actually a developer, so whatever I've designed is basically from a user's point of view. Here we have the landing page, and for this I have used colors like orange and blue, which signifies things like success and trust. I've used Roboto font for this because it is a professional font, and since we are designing a professional website, I have used sans serif. I have opted for using using geometric shapes in a abstract way, and I think that is what is catching the user's attention over here in this page. Yeah, in the next page, I'm just collecting the data for the student branch. Here, I've tried to create an uneven pattern on purpose in the form. And I feel these are those tiny imperfections that is what makes the design more appealing. And this is the submission page. As you can see, the submit button is disabled without login, and there's a link to login, and there would be a pop-up which asks for the user login. And in the next page, you can see the next page is the events page. I have come up with a card design. It has the background image with the topic that is being held in the event. I've created small elements which give a lot of info on a single glance. And if there is more info to read about it, they can just click on read more, and it would be redirecting to a events page. And yeah, this is a page nation that I've built that scrolls to the right side. And this is the contact us page. I've just kept the motif clear here, and I've just reduced all the clutter and removed all the unwanted info so that this would be clear to contact IEEE. And this is the design that I've approached.
So Pranav, dude, looks beautiful, dude. I like the geometric shapes personally, right? And it really looks nice. So at the same time, I just want to know why one of the testimonial is hidden, right? But let's say I'm just trying to read two testimonials, and I'm trying to read the third one.
Yeah.
I can't read the entire thing. So why is that?
This is a scrollable. I mean, it's not manually scrollable. It is automatically moving to the left.
Okay, so when it is automatically moved to the left, the testimonials title will be covered, is it?
No. This the first card would go to the last.
Okay.
Sort of like a queue.
Cool. So okay, it's going to okay. So it's a tough animation, but as a developer, you know, it's very hard to create that kind of animation. But yeah, I'm trying to visualize how it is possible. But yeah, good thinking, dude. But yeah, again, at the same time, even the upcoming events, right?
Mm-hmm.
So maybe we need an CTA to go somewhere, or maybe you see, I don't feel it's crawlable. for some reason. It's like one entire thing, one entire block
yes.
or a
card. Yes.
Maybe
yes.
it could be a little bit scrollable where I can feel that, yeah, it's scrollable and something like that. I don't
okay.
get the feel that it's scrollable. That's what I know for a fact it is when I try
mm-hmm.
to concentrate. But
mm-hmm.
for a nav user who's quickly trying to scroll, he will not understand if it is scrollable or not. Okay, that's one
yes.
thing.
Yes.
And I feel the text on the left side is very, very small. Like, what's the font size of that?
I think 14, yeah.
14, yeah, but 14 is good enough. But yeah, maybe a little bit of like 18 or something would do
mm-hmm.
the job. But yeah, it's good, dude. It's good enough. Can you go to the next slide? Yeah, I think this looks cool. Yeah. But again, you told on purpose you created an uneven pattern of text
yeah.
fields.
Mm-hmm.
Why is it venue? What is venue? Do you mean location?
Location of the event, yeah.
Okay. So his student is trying to enter his details, right? Like
No. The members are submitting their details over here.
Awesome. So they submit the location, right?
Yeah.
Okay, no worries. So next, dude. Yeah, see, here, you see the information is completely, the image is completely covered by the information.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Maybe you could have used like image on the top and then there could be, info on the bottom.
Okay.
Somewhere you're covering the entire image. See, there's no point even keeping the image because I can't see. There's an
yes.
Ethereum workshop, but I don't know what it is. Is it? It's a coin, but I don't know. Is it a gold coin? What it is? I don't know. Right. So
yes.
maybe you could have, worked on that. And
mm-hmm.
can you go to the bottom? Here, I don't see it's a text field at all. See, for example,
mm-hmm.
your name. Okay, it's already pre-filled, but as a user, when I come down to fill it, I don't know where to fill.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Yeah.
So maybe it could be a small text field, like it's a small outline kind of a thing where I can
outline,
fill.
Yeah.
Things, right.
Exactly. Yeah.
That would be awesome, right?
Yes.
And great job, dude. Yeah. So hope the feedback is helpful, and I think great job. Like overall, like I see the small details, like geometric. It could be geometric kind of a thing, and the IEEE's put up here. So it's really nice. I like the detailing of the design. Kudos
sure.
to the visual design.
Thank you.
A little bit of on functionality would be awesome, but yeah, there's always room to improvement, right? Good job, dude, Pranav. Really good job.
Sure. Thank you so much.
Yeah, Pranav, top notch visual design, like really
okay.
good. I really like the whole way you actually use the colors, the way you presented it, the way you use the abstract the geometric shape.
Thank you.
Even the smaller details like the white background behind the white stroke around the photos, right? Circular photos, these
mm-hmm.
things really add to the whole feel of it.
Thank you.
The font size, again, yeah, coming to the font size, it seems a little too small. I'm guessing that's because it's matched with the larger font on the top. So it's looking like out of place at the
smaller,
moment.
Smaller, yeah.
So you can probably look at that. And the color might be seeming a little too light, or is it because it's 14? So again, like because it's 14 and the color is a little less, it seems that it's too small. As I mean, the hierarchy is very less as well, right? Even though the
mm-hmm.
text is a lot. So now the way you can so two things, like improve the hierarchy of that place. Second is like reduce the description of that. Catch, as I was telling previously to other people also, like just catch the essence of the message that you want to convey.
Mm-hmm.
What Vaishnav said, have like some sort of a right arrow or left arrow button so that there's like a clear
upcoming.
For the upcoming
mm-hmm.
events.
Yeah.
I like the way you presented the upcoming events. Like it's well done. Just few little more detailing can be done over there. Otherwise, it looks pretty great.
Okay.
Testimonials, yeah. Testimonials, pretty cool. One thing I wanted to understand is that, it's testimonials really good. I was just testimonials, right? Not testimonies. Okay.
Oh yeah, there's nothing. Yeah.
The thing is that I'm not able to imagine like some. The thing would automatically. Now this is like more deeper. The thing is that the card when it goes behind the testimonies.
Mm-hmm.
It, it'll seem out of place when it's just disappearing off because it's not naturally disappearing off. There seems to be some sort of a background up front, but we haven't visually talked about any background, right? Like there's no shadow preventing it going behind anything. But that's just the smaller detail. Okay, can you go to the events page? So over here now, SCT events, right? Because it's a event, it's like a list of events that I want to see. Generally, horizontal scroll is not a good idea to when you're actually going when you actually want to view events, because I'm not it's not a the it's harder to view events, further events, when you have it in a horizontal scroll.
Horizontal, yeah.
Whereas if you have it like in a vertical scroll, right, it's like you can keep scrolling and you can show more information also that way. So that's one. And generally horizontal scroll would be also at a place where you want to explore, where the person doesn't know what to do over here. Here the person wants to it's like the kind of information, the kind of horizontal scroll is much better for the kind of information. So me for like let's say in Swiggy itself, we don't know like what type of food category they want to actually scroll through. So it'll be under like different categories as well, and then you can scroll through like these are the different restaurants also that you can try out, and then below you can have like a more vertical listing that actually like just which is based on distance. But in this there's always like this idea that we don't know who you as a user, that who like what you want, and that's when the horizontal scroll becomes important, because if the first three things can catch you, then you'll click on see all and then the vertical listing will come up. Here you can use the same vertical listing here itself, because they're coming to view the events itself. They're not, if someone's coming over here, they're not like have any other idea. If you had divided it into like categories within the events, SCT events, then it would make sense to have see all for each category. But here you don't have category, right? You just have events. So that way you can just go down.
Sure, got it.
And so that's one. And okay, so in the this thing, can you go to the top, which is the SP data? So here I see that you've asked fewer information compared to like I think like some people had asked more information, right? Like student, the site, the chancellor's name. Like, do you think that's not important?
I think when they log in, the info is obtained automatically.
And so you don't have to re-enter it. Got it. You don't have to change it also that way.
I don't think that can be changed.
Okay. Then makes sense. Then this works. I also wanted to understand why the why do you think the misalignment in the text field actually makes it more appealing?
I don't know, the varying length of the fields, it just catches my eye.
Okay, got it. Got it. Sure. Cool. Otherwise, this works pretty well. Otherwise, everything else looks pretty perfect. Where is the also where is the logo for IEEE?
Oh yeah, I haven't used the logo here.
Cool, no issues. Yeah, that's something that would be necessary, right? Smart
Exactly.
organization.
Yeah.
Yeah. Otherwise, great job, dude. Like, amazing job.
Thank you.
Could help with some feedback.
Sure. Thank you.
Cool.
Hey, Pranav.
Hello.
So overall, I like the entire design. One thing that is standing out is your contrast seems to be a little low throughout the this thing. At least on the home page, the description you have written, the description about the event, the description about SCT SP, because the text is too much. I mean, those are like 4 or 5 lines, and the text size is smaller, and then the contrast is lower, so it's I mean not readable, I feel. Other than that, I think, and similarly for your navigation bar, the contrast is a little on the lower end. And instead of using a gray, maybe you can use black with a lower opacity because it's on the white background. Then, so here, upcoming events, you are also like they're gonna scroll automatically.
Automatically.
And this entire card is tappable, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So here the date and the text size you've used, is it again 14?
Oh yeah, this is 12 and this is 14.
Right. Yeah, so maybe, you know, I think working on the contrast would make it, would do all this
work. Yeah.
Exactly. I really like the testimonial section. Let's move, scroll down. Again, I think white on yellow is sort of creating some issue, else it's all good.
Okay.
This looks really cool, the image and then a card on it. But here, the again, the font size you have used for these tags, which is date and location, is it again? I feel it's too small.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, because, you know, the description is the information that you want the user to read. It's not something which is not important, right?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
14 exactly. Or 16 should be the minimum so that it's normal for the user to read. He doesn't need to put in too much of effort.
Yes.
Yeah, I really like the shapes and the color combination you have used. Let's move down. And here the way you have used the progress bar, right? That's really different and nice. Instead of using those three dots to show the pagination, it's a cool idea.
Thank you.
Yeah, quite lean. Nice. So what does this button do? The send button?
Oh, it sends the query to IEEE.
Okay, so this message is editable?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I thought it's a filled form.
No, all of this is editable.
Oh, okay, all these are the inputs.
Yeah, it is a text input.
Okay, cool. This is theek hai, yeah. All the best, dude.
Thank you.
Okay, I guess we are done with all the participants for the day. Yeah, hope everyone presented right. So we are done with the participants. So we are at the end of the today's event. So I'd like to thank our judges for patiently answering, giving them so valuable and so very good feedback to them, to their designs. Hope it was very useful to them. So yeah. I would like to share a virtual plaque on behalf of our team. Thank you, Divya, for for being a judge for today's event, and thank you so much. And I hope all the participants had a very good feedback on their designs.
Thanks for inviting. I really had a great time, and that's so sweet of you.
Oh, okay. So yeah, before that, I just like we can announce the result if it's ready.
Is some network issue happening, or is it just at my end?
I think there is some network issue.
Yeah, okay.
There is a lag.
Cool.
I would like to ask, like, if the results are ready, if yes, we can go ahead with the results. Judges?
I think we will fill the form, right, Ruben?
Okay. So yeah, anything is fine. Yeah, actually, yeah.
The presentations were quite amazing. They were very smooth. So, does any participant want to share their experience of 24 hours of these designathon?
Yeah, hi there. One thing from 24 hours, it was a very great thing, a great, amazing time to spend, because usually we get to design some posters or something like that uniquely, but when they say you have to design something specifically with a theme and you have all freedom to do whatever you are expecting for, that's pretty amazing. And even the insights what the judges gave throughout the time, they are very valuable. I mean, we won't able to get those kind of insights from anywhere else if it's not IEEE panel section. Thanks for that. It was a great time. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Subramanya. Judges, you guys have, all three of you have given so many valuable inputs, so many deep insights to every participants with so much care that like even after so much of insights, I still feel like there is something more we all want to hear from your end. So if you could please speak a few words, that would be really amazing.
Definitely. See, I think it was an amazing event, first of all. And secondly, what I want to say for participants is, like, see, our job is to give feedback right here. So always try to take this feedback very positively, you know, so that you guys can improve on, right? So right now, we didn't get very, very technical and very, very advanced also, basically on the basic level, because when we gave this basic level feedback, it's because we wanted to be more actionable. Right. So once you get this feedbacks on, like, maybe hierarchy, spacing, or user experience, what happens is you guys can quickly take that feedback and make it more actionable, make it more, like you guys can learn a lot from this. Right. So definitely was a great event and amazing designs. Right. All the best, folks. Really happy to see you guys come up with all these presentations. Good job.
Same here, guys. Thanks for inviting. Had a great evening. And everyone has done such a great job in just 24 hours. So hats off to all of you for coming up with some amazing outputs. And of course, everything can be improved every fucking time. So even if you would have done it for 1 week, again, there would have been some things that can you work, you know, that you can work upon and make them better. So yeah, I mean, feedback is just it's just a loop. It's a never-ending loop. So as Vaishnu said, take it positively, try working on them and see what differences it makes. Because once you work on the feedback you get next time, and if you take action on it next time, it's going to stay with you. Those pointers would stay in your mind for the upcoming design. So those mistakes are not going to repeat in. Hope you guys got something valuable from all the feedback today, and all the best.
Yeah, guys. A really great job with all the presentation, all the work that you guys did in just 24 hours. I personally find it hard to do all that. So that's like hats off to all of you. The feedback, again, like it's easy to give feedback. I understand, like, it's harder to actually work, right? Like to do it with the constraints that you guys had, and to present like what you guys actually presented. Actually, that's like a lot. So it's like commendable, and feedback is the easy part over here, which is what we were here for. But hopefully it could we could help with whatever we could provide. And that's a great job. Hope you see the feedback also, like, so in design, one thing for sure is that, like, feedback is a thing that will constantly be there on a daily basis. I get feedback on pretty much a daily basis and never see that as like a thing that your design sucks or anything. It's just a one step to improve your design, and just see like what, and sometimes also just see like what aligns with you also. Don't blindly accept what everyone says, like what I would have told you. Like, see if it aligned with whatever you guys were already thinking, because there would be more context to what you already thought, right? And you might have not been able to communicate it. So always have a balanced approach as well, and see it as a way to improve your design, but at the same time, just see that you can also like have your own flair. So that is it. All the best, guys, for your future endeavors.
Results will be declared in any moment now, but before we go ahead, like, I would like to add on to what the judges said. And surviving 24 hours is not so easy. So does any participant want to tell us how they tackled the 24 hours, how they divided their time, or any tip, something like that?
Is there any network issue or no one is speaking?
The chat box is really active, so people are voicing out there.
All of us are just finalizing on the results on the back end, so I think there's a little bit of
By the time the results get announced, the participants can share your feedback, like, throughout the process, how you felt and till now, till the presentation. We would love to hear your feedback.
Rubini, I think we can move towards announcing the results. I think the judges have entered this course, just confirming once if they're final. If they are, then we can go ahead and make the announcement.
Okay. So I would like to share the results now. Let me present my screen. So, yeah, congratulations to both of you guys. The runner-up is Raksha, and the winner of the UX and UI event is Pranav MS.
Thank you so much.
hearty congratulations to both the winners. And just to, I guess, let the participants know, the competition was very close. There's a very small margin between both the winner and the runners-up. So, great job, everybody.
Thank you so much.
We will mail you for the other details. So stay tuned on the mail. No event is ever complete without the judges, and we are so thankful and we are so grateful to have such valuable judges for this event who spent their time, made their effort, and gave everyone such valuable inputs throughout the event for all the participants. And I hope not only the participants, but we as organizers also have so much more to learn from all the judges. So I would like to present a small token of appreciation to all our judges. A small token of appreciation to our judge, Vaishnav Ramayan. Thank you so much for being here with us. A small token of appreciation to Ms. Divya Bhatia. Thank you so much for being here with us, ma'am. And a small token of appreciation for Vishnu Madhavan sir, who agreed to be with us for this event today and helped us judge the event. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, guys. We had a great time.
Thanks for having me, guys.
Thank you, sir. That brings us to the end of this event. All the best, guys. Bye-bye. Have a good night.
All the best, guys.